در هر دو دقیقه پلیس در یک صحنه خشونت خانگی در استرالیا حضور می‌یابد. در هر روز 8 زن به دلیل ضرب و شتم توسط همسرانشان در شفاخانه بستری می‌شوند و در هر هفته یک زن توسط همسر فعلی یا سابق خود به قتل می‌رسد. اما بدرفتاری خانگی شاید همیشه شامل خشونت فیزیکی نباشد. این پدیده اغلب به شکل کنترل قهری یا اجباری ظاهر می شود.
And essentially what coercive control is a number of behaviors or tactics that are used by an individual against an individual or by family members against family members. And it is essentially to isolate the victim, to degrade them, to threaten them, to alternate punishments with rewards. So, you know, sometimes everything is lovely. Maybe there's apologies for behaviors, regrets. I won't ever do it again. And then the behavior resumes. There is stalking and surveillance.
The most insidious thing about all those forms of abuse was that you can mistake them for someone having an intense interest in you. It's just completely devastated me.
قربانیان این گونه خشونت می توانند از عزت نفس پایینی برخوردار باشند و کمخوابی، خستگی و انزوای اجتماعی را تجربه کنند. آنها معمولاً مورد خشونت مالی نیز قرار می گیرند و دسترسیشان به پول قطع می شود.
The effect of it is depression, anxiety, a feeling that like you don't have any friends and you start to think it's because it's something that you're doing. But when in fact, it's actually the perpetrator driving all those people away from you so that they can better control you. And when people say like, oh, well, why don't people just leave these situations? You're so exhausted and working so hard to survive psychologically and physically. The idea of leaving, particularly if you're a migrant, particularly if you're on a temporary visa, is so complex.
بسیاری از قربانیان کنترل اجباری در استرالیا زنان مهاجر دارای ویزاهای موقت هستند و در برخی از جوامع مهاجر سوء استفاده می تواند اشکال پیچیده تری به خود بگیرد.
I've seen reproductive coercion occur. So sometimes partners, husbands intentionally trying to get the woman pregnant without her consent to keep her in the abusive relationship. That's one example. On another example, I've seen where, the woman or the wife has wanted to keep the child, but if the husband and the in-laws family do not wish for her to have a child, have forced that woman to have an abortion.
I've tried to seek help from the police, but I don't have the kind of bruise or like a typical things on my face, and there's nothing I can prove to them. I told them that I'm scared to go home, I don't know what to do. They said, if anything, you can just call 000.
Okay.
کنترل اجباری نشانه های واضحی دارد و مهم است که آنها را بشناسیم.
If you feel like you're having to ask for an allowance or you're not having access to money, that is a really big one. If you feel like you're being isolated from friends and family, either you're being told you can't see them or your partner's just making it really hard for you to see them. If you feel like they are constantly belittling you or degrading you, making threats to harm themselves if you leave, threats to harm pets, threats to hurt or kill the kids. These sorts of behaviors are the big, not red flags for future abuse. This is the abuse.
اگر شما یا کسی از دوستان و آشنایانتان با خشونت خانوادگی روبرو هستید، با شماره 1800-737-732 به 1800 رسپکت زنگ بزنید یا از وبسایت 1800respect.org.au دیدن کنید. جهت دریافت مشاوره برای مردانی که اختلال عصبانیت دارند یا در رابطه یا فرزندداری مشکل دارند، با شماره 1300-766-491 به مرکز خدمات ارجاع مردان زنگ بزنید یا از نشانه ntv.org.au دیدن کنید. در حالت اضطراری به شماره 30 زنگ بزنید.